Hello, with Annette here. In these next stories of bad movie production, there are aviation accidents. Humans being injured by sand, explosives gone wrong and a train accident that could have been absolutely disastrous. Before any further ado, we're going to start with. This movie consisted of an aerobatic disaster. The Skywayman. Directed by James P. Hogan, this 1920 silent movie was produced by Fox Film Corporation. This movie showcased some breathtaking aerial acrobats by Omar Locklear, who played Captain Norman Craig. Omar was known to be a talented stuntman. Omar also made it to the ranks of lieutenant in the Air Force. Omar was reluctant to perform in this movie at first. On the 2nd of August 1920, Omar Locklear and co-pilot Milton Elliott, who was a pro stuntman, were killed during filming night scenes in Los Angeles. When their plane by chance crashed at the DeMille airfield along Wilshire Boulevard. This movie was released to take advantage of the men's deaths. Through time, the Skywayman has been lost, as it is thought no footage exists. This movie depicts the times when the Spanish invaded South America. The Woman God Forgot. Directed by Cecil B. DeMille, this 1917 romantic movie, if it can be called that in today's standards, is about the Spaniards taking over Aztec cities and slaughtering them all, only leaving one Aztec female named Tezca, played by Julie Fay. Tezca is the daughter of King Moctezuma, played by Raymond Hatton. Tezca falls in love with a Spanish captain, Alvarado, played by Wallace Reed. A pyramid was built for this movie made of wood and paper. To give the pyramid the look of genuineness, sand was glued on the sides. During a scene, extras were thrown off this pyramid. The production crew must have thought something was going to go wrong. As the extras were cut by the sand, a crew member was waiting at the bottom with a bucket of iodine. The only surviving copy of this movie is held in the George Eastman House Picture Collection. This movie depicts those who crave the need to control. The 11th Hour. Directed by Bernard J. Durning, this 1923 action movie is based on a play by Lincoln J. Carter. This movie was produced by Fox Film Corporation. It is about Prince Stefan de Berny, played by Alan Hale, who wants to take over the world, but Brick McDonald, played by Buck Jones, prevents Prince Stefan from doing so. This movie contains armed vehicles and other kinds of weaponry. Dick Kerwood, who worked as a stunt pilot, reached the skies in a standard J biplane with multiple explosives on board. These were set to detonate after Dick jumped out of the plane. However, the mechanics for the timer was faulty, which caused the explosives to detonate early. As the biplane exploded, Dick was projected out. Dick must have been highly shocked and dazed after this, but he still managed to react as he opened his parachute. Dick was not unscathed, as this incident left him with a serious concussion. Some comedies are just funny due to production mistakes. Sherlock Jr. This 1924 film was directed by Buster Keaton, who also played the main role of Sherlock Jr. When production of this silent comedy began, it was earlier titled The Misfit. Roscoe Arbuckle, who was the co-director of this movie, was known as William Goodrick for the production. As Roscoe had been accused of raping Virginia Rapp in 1921, which led to a court case, where the outcome left Roscoe losing cars and a mansion. Roscoe also had a $750,000 debt to pay for his crime. Roscoe was not the easiest person for Buster to work with, as Roscoe would shout aggressively at the cast members. In the end, Buster booted Roscoe out of the production. Marion Harlan was earlier given the role to play the girl, but unluckily Marion became sick, so she had to be replaced by Catherine McGuire. Buster Keaton was known for performing his own stunts, like vanishing into a small suitcase, and Buster manages to walk in the film that is being screened on stage, after leaving the projection room and walking into the theater. This even astonished other cameramen in the industry, to how Buster was able to do things like these. Not all of Buster's stunts went well. While the scene was being filmed, Buster Keaton was on a moving boxcar train. Buster grabbed a water spout which ended up on Buster harder than hoped for, which made Buster thrown of the moving engine and onto the tracks. Buster's head hit the steel rail which caused him to black out. Buster postponed filming for the rest of the day, but he did return to the production without receiving any medical attention, as Buster was known to have a high pain threshold. It was not until 9 years after the train incident, Buster attended a medical clinic for an X-ray. That is when Buster found out he had really broken his neck at the top vertebra. In 1991, this movie was recognized by the Library of Congress as being culturally and historically substantial, which is now preserved in the United States National Film Registry. The American Film Institute ranked Sherlock Jr. 62 in the list of most funniest films of all time in 2000, as part of the American Film Institute's 100th year celebration. Some comedies are highly controversial for their humor. Haunted Spooks. This silent gothic comedy was co-directed by Hal Roach in 1920. It starred Harold Lloyd, who played the boy. On the 9th of August 2019, production of this movie began. When Harold was posing for photographers to gain publicity, Harold picked up a prop bomb that ended up exploding, which left him temporarily blinded. Harold was left with burns on his face as well as losing two fingers, which caused the production to be halted on the 23rd of August 2019. On the 5th of January 1920, production commenced once again after Harold recovered from his injuries. Harold took part and he concealed his fingers by wearing a prosthetic glove, as he did not want the sympathy from viewers. Filming came to an end on the 25th of January 1920. The filming of the indoor scenes took place at Hal Roach Studios, in Culver City, California, while the outdoor scenes were filmed at MacArthur Park, known back then as Hancock Park. This production is known to be a racist movie in today's standards. It shows the knees trembling and wide eyes of scared black servants, but one or two more servants were white with boot polish on their faces. When Harold returned to this production, his salary doubled. Then after production, Harold turned his back on slapstick comedy and moved on to other comedies like Intellect and Romance. Thank you for listening. Please like and subscribe. Press that notification bell to keep up to date with my videos, or follow me on Twitter @withanet1.